Today, it's time to put my game dev chops to the test. I'm going to attempt to make a game in Unreal Engine 5 in just 1 hour. My workflow typically involves spending days at a time iterating and polishing mechanics until they're just right before deciding they're not necessary and completely trashing them. Because of this, it has been some time now since I've finished a solo project, and if I'm gonna be here making videos telling y'all how to make video games, I feel like I best be better able to make games. Let's just get started. I'd say that the most important part to finishing your game on schedule is proper planning. That's not what happens in this video, though. Save the first and most crucial thing, this is the planning of a man who hasn't taken part in a game jam in over a year and thinks that it's possible to implement basic gameplay, an item system, a weapon system, enemies, and top all of that off with some juicy polish in just an hour. I mean, maybe it's possible, who knows? Definitely not you or me telling you or you hearing spoilers. So one blank project later, we set off. Unreal Engine works with inheritance, so we can cut out half of the work for the AI by just making the AI and the player derive from the same character. The base character needs to be able to hold a weapon, or else nothing's gonna be able to pew pew. We also need to be able to make sure that the player can see their own weapon in their camera. Once the characters have pew pew potential, they also need to have health, so the pew pew potential is potent. Then I set up the weapon class, which if you couldn't already tell is just gonna be a cube. Now we can go take a look and see if that's working. Wait, where's the weapon? Okay, no, I got this. We just need to see where it's spawning. I'm gonna set it back to the default size and it's still not here. Oh, okay, I see what's happening here. I just need to make sure that it ignores collision and always spawns. And what? Okay, can we see a print string? Oh, remember that inheritance thing? Yeah, we need to call the parent class's begin play in the player class, or else none of this is gonna work. Classy. So, we do that, hit play, and I detach the attach node. At this point, we were about halfway through, and still nothing could pew pew, which is the main mechanic of the game, so I set up a projectile. Here's some blueprint logic of the trace that detects if the cube is hitting a pawn. I opted for this because out of everything that could go wrong in this project, inconsistent colliders is not gonna be one of them. Was this more important than sound? Was this more important than particles? I don't know, but I definitely spent the time anyway, because that's what I do. Now that we can pew pew projectiles with potentially potent power, we can make a rectangle holding a cube hover towards us menacingly. They also need to be able to defend themselves. Now they can defend themselves, but they can also hit themselves, so maybe we should fix that. The win and lose conditions still aren't done yet, but you know what? Now's a great time to implement a main menu. Yep, time to make the main menu. I guess we might as well make the in-game menu while we're at it. It probably also helps if we can see our mouse in the menus. When an enemy defeats the player, you're sent back to the main menu. Before we can set up the win condition though, we do need a way of keeping track of the enemies. In fact, we need a way of spawning the enemies. So, here's some logic for the enemy spawners. The important thing to note is the event dispatcher, which will allow us to keep track of how many enemies have been defeated. To make sure that the player can win the game, I made the game mode locate the enemy spawner and bound an event from the spawner to pass through when enemies die, and made a super fancy win widget so winning isn't as jarring as losing. Really, all that's left to do now is spawn the level with spawn points so you never know where the next cube boy is gonna come from. Oh, wait, there's no HUD yet. It's also kind of weird not being able to see the enemy's health, so here's something for that as well. Still no sounds or particles, but sure, yeah, this was more important. And that's time. It may not be the best looking game, or the best feeling game, or the most fun game, or a relaxing game, or the most exciting game, or an award-winning game, or the worst confusing game, or a game where you drink former game. But it's a game. Although Unreal Engine is an amazing tool for making prototypes quickly, there are multiple layers to that, which I will cover in future videos. So if you're interested in seeing how to utilize Unreal Engine in a much more meaningful way, make sure to like that subscribe button and notify the bell. For now, hopefully this was helpful to anyone who's interested in making their first game and don't know where to start, or maybe it gave you a laugh. Who knows? But what I can say is there is a front-end menu, there's a goal, the player can win, and best of all, the player can lose. Wait, are those in the right order? But you can't even jump! Why did developers always feel the need to steal my f***ing jump?